Shalom and welcome to 2 Minutes of Torah. This shir is entitled, maybe instead of only mourning for the Mikdash, we should start building the Mikdash. It's an incredible thing. Jews are doers. Can you imagine in Europe, they're told you can't do Mila. Okay, we can't do Mila. We'll wait for God to scream out from the heavens to do Mila. He'll send a moel from Shemayim and wipe out the government in Europe who's prohibiting Mila, and then we'll do Mila again. Never would happen. The Jews are going to be so proactive. Can't keep Shabbos. You must drive on Shabbos. They're going to fight in tooth and nail. Proactive. When it comes to Mikdash, somehow, we just wait it out. And the question is that legitimate? Just do tshuva and tshuva and tshuva, hope for God that God will intervene? Or should we go ahead, get our tools, and start building the Mikdash? And if the government doesn't let us, then have hafkanot, have demonstrations, and push the agenda like we do Shmirat Shabbat, giving our Kush Katif 15 years ago, we're all protested. So should we be proactive about building the Mikdash? That's a simple question. And we're talking about hundreds of mitzvahs connected to the Mikdash. The simple pshat at first glance before delving into the sugi is, of course we should be proactive. When do we find mitzvahs that we wait for? The Rami Geras Hashmad says, we don't wait for Mashiach to do mitzvahs, we do mitzvahs now. So we need a source to say, oh, this mitzvah of Mikdash, Korbanos, and Tumah, Tahara, Sanhedrin, oh, that we have to wait it out. We need a source. Simple pshat seems to be, let's get moving. Yetzer Hashem will explore this topic. Shalom.